now what we're talking about is heart failure, meaning that when the heart is unable to do its job. And most people think when you have heart failure, you have a weak heart. But the heart doesn't necessarily need to be weak. It could be stiff. And that's actually more common than a weak heart when we say heart failure. So a lot of our community has high blood pressure, diabetes. Those things make the heart stiff. And as a result, the heart is unable to do its job well. And one of the most common manifestations of heart failure is backup of fluid into the body. So when you have leg swelling, you can't breathe, you gain weight unexpectedly, those are all symptoms of heart failure. Everybody following me? Anybody have any questions? Now, heart failure, like most conditions, disproportionately affects us. I get a little frustrated when we talk about disparities because it's like, how can we keep describing the same thing over and over again? All right, black people die more this, that, and the third. But it's true. And I'm gonna separate that discussion. That's a whole different discussion for another day. But suffice it to say, we are afflicted at a higher clip when it comes to heart failure. And again, it's because of the chronic conditions that exist in our community. In fact, black men are 70% more likely than white women to get heart failure. Black women are 50% more likely than white women to get heart failure. And when it comes to death, admissions to the hospital, we are multiple times more likely to get afflicted with those conditions. Now, in terms of what to do, obviously, we doctors talk about medications all the time, but I am not one of those doctors, okay? Meaning that I would prefer if you didn't have to do the medication, okay? And in order to prevent you from ending up on medication, you have to first focus on prevention. So the time to prevent and treat heart failure is now, when you don't have it. But once you do have it, lifestyle is important, meaning that the more you move your body, the less preserved foods that you eat, meaning things that are not outside of the box. So anything that is fresh that will perish within a week or so, that's what you want to put into your body. And again, moving is important. So if you start doing that now, that allows your arteries to stay open, your heart to stay strong, and your circulatory system to do what it's supposed to do. And then if you do have heart failure, I am happy to say that we have some advanced therapeutics that we can bring to bear. But again, I would want to use that as a last ditch effort to treat you. And so I think it's important for our community to not only understand what is the leading cause of death in our community, which is cardiovascular disease and how to prevent it, but what your options are. And you know, I practice cardiology not too far from here. And if any of you want to come by and just get a consultation, pull on up. I take most insurances, but if you say that you're from this church, I will do it free of charge. Just review your records, okay? Because it's very important that you are empowered, because too many of us are getting lost into this healthcare system. And as a result, we're having poor outcomes. And one of the reasons why I opened, well, the main reason I opened up my practice was to provide care to anyone that needs it. So I would never turn anybody away, and I will always focus on empowering patients. And that's what I hope that I've done today. Thank you.